Good morning, students. Now we have started our sixth unit nanotechnology. And in the last lecture, we have seen about the introduction of nanotechnology. What is it? And expert lecture of Dr. Karandikar sir from Army Institute of Technology was also there in the last lecture. So you have come to know much about nanotechnology. He explained various topics related to nanotechnology, research scope, various learning resources, and all information about nanotechnology you got from expert lecture. So today we'll start with nanowires in this session, and then one by one topic we'll cover. I would like to complete this unit in this week only. If possible, let me know about extra lecture or free lecture so that we can be able to complete this nanotechnology. And then we'll start with our last unit, magnetic materials. And this week I will just explain about the practical optional activities, two optional activities. And I would like to tell you now, those who don't have selected optional activities, they can select virtual visits. Number of YouTubes are there, visit to substation or any related to electrical engineering scope. Okay, visit to substation, visit to suppose material innovation lab. You just search in YouTube online virtual tour of electrical engineering, power system, generating station, and that video you can just explain as a your optional activity, one optional activity, and the sound of video you will mute, and then you will explain. You will just run the picture and this, you will explain yourself. And then after explaining yourself, then you can just again start video with the sound. Okay. So start searching, and then from next week, I will just start conducting optional activity. Other activities we have completed about practical way. Okay. And practically three experiments will perform. Only three experiments are remaining. Six experiments are completed. Okay. But for few persons who were not available, they haven't completed sixth experiment. I will repeat it. Okay. So let us start with nanowire. Okay. Nanotechnology, you know, now let us see nanowires. Before that, just what are the characteristics of nanoparticles? Just I would like to revise what also Karandikar sir told. So if you see the characteristics of nanoparticles, they have large surface to volume ratio. Why large surface to volume ratio? Because any one dimension of a device or a particle, or you can just say it has to be very less in the nano range. So as one dimension will be very large, other dimensions will be large. So surface to volume ratio will be large. And due to this large surface to volume ratio, they will have some special properties and applications. They have high percentage of atoms, molecules on the surface, because you just see surface will be high and volume will be less. Okay, that's why this ratio will become high. Surface forces are very important, while bulk forces are not as important. So as surface will be large, percentage of atoms, molecule on the surface will be large, but volume will be less because one dimension will be in the nano range. So surface forces will be large and they are important. Metal nanoparticles have unique light scattering properties and exhibit plasmon resonance. So even if these nanoparticles or nanowires, even if they will be very small in dimension, even if they will be one dimension, we have seen one dimensional, two dimensional, three dimensional. So even if they are very small size, one dimensional, they have peculiar properties of light scattering properties, and this light scattering properties will be used. Okay. And semiconducting nanoparticles may exhibit confined energy state, because these nanoparticles are also classified as metal semiconductors. Okay. So when semiconductor nanoparticles, they will exhibit confined energy states in their electronic band structure. Okay. Are you listening me, students? Because I just heard the noise. Today we don't have a network in college. I am using my personal network. Okay. Can you listen me? Students, are you listening me? So what are the physical properties of nanoparticles? Physical properties of nanoparticles depend upon the size, shape, whether they are spherical, rods, platelets, composition, crystal structure, surface, and then you can just say what agents are added and the medium in which they are dispersed. So some examples of your unusual properties, special properties. So load phase transition temperature, increase mechanical strength. Even if they are having small dimensions, mechanical strength will be very high. Different optical properties. Just I told you, light scattering means it's a optical properties, different optical properties. And I think number of optical properties are very useful. So altered electrical conductivity. Conductivity will be also altered. Magnetic properties will be altered. Because in the definition of nanotechnology, only we have seen it's not only one dimension has to be very small, but properties has to be tremendously changed. And as the change in properties will be there, then only we will have benefits of nanotechnology. So they will have altered conductivity. Magnetic properties will be also very good and different than convenient means conventional magnetic materials. Unique biological response and unique chemical reactivity. So these are some special properties of nanoparticles. Now we will just see nanowires. Now we'll just see about the nanowires. Okay, so nanowires means what? So background of nanowires are just like normal electrical wires. Wire, you are connecting one connection to the another connections with the wire. But how much length, how much diameter of wire you are using, you are just seeing with your eyes, your wires, and just connecting with longer length. But when nanowires are there, they will be very tiny, one dimensional. Okay, we have seen one dimensional nanowires are one dimensional, and diameter will be very small, length will be very small, any one dimension. And according to different literature, you will get different definition of nanowire. I will just demonstrate you. So be confined to any one literature. Okay, generally in exams short notes will be asked. Okay, so nanowires are just like normal electrical wires, but as it is nano, you will just see diameter will be very small. One dimension has to be very small. Okay, but the fact is they are extremely small. Like conventional wires, nanowires can be made from a variety of conducting and semi. I just now told you, like conventional materials, materials, nanoparticles, nanomaterials can be also classified into different classes, like conventional, like conducting, semiconducting. So that is applicable for nanowires, that is applicable for nano carbon tubes, for nanotubes everywhere. So nanowires will be also made up from metals or semiconductors. So they are copper, silver, gold, iron, silicon, zinc oxide, and germanium. And depending upon the material composition, properties will change. So nanowires can be made from carbon nanotubes. We want to study these carbon nanotubes in detail, okay? So nanowires are also used in carbon nanotubes. So nanowires less than 100 nanometers. Dr. Karandikar sir also told the definition same way. Nanowires have less diameter than 100 nanometers, okay? And can be as small as 3 nanometers, okay? So up to diameter. So here this literature is telling that nanowires are having diameter very less, but some literature I am just getting difference. Okay, so typically nanowires are more than 1000 times longer than their diameter. So what is here? It is said length is more, but diameter will not be very large, and it has to be less than 100 nanometers. Okay, so remember this because he also said that way. So, a nanowire is connecting structure because as it is a wire, it will require to connect. And what will be required to connect? Of course, in the nano applications. So, when you are using nanotechnology, and in that nanotechnology to do small tiny connections, nanowires will be used. So, a nanowire is a connecting structure that has a diameter of 10 raised to minus 9 meters, okay, which is extremely small, also known as quantum wires. These connectors are used to connect tiny components together into very small circuits and that small circuits will be of course used in the nanotechnology. So these structures are no larger than a 1/10 of a nanometer wide. Okay, there is no restriction on how wide they can grow. So diameter is small, but how wide they can grow, there is no restrictions, but cannot grow more than a few nanometers in height. So here height constraint is also mentioned. Now what it says, a nano wires are microscopic wires because you will not see with your naked eyes. Okay, already I told you, you cannot see, that will be used in nanotechnology. So nano wires are microscopic wires that have a width measured in nanometers. Typically their width ranges from 40 to 50 nanometers, but their length is not so limited. So length is not limited since they can be lengthened by simply attaching more wire ends to it, or just by growing them longer, they can be as long as desired. So length can be more, but diameter are less. So these are some microscopic views of nanowires. See this. They can grow wide, means width can be very large because that will be used for connections. But diameter you can just see very less. So here diameter is 5 micrometer, here 200 nanometer. So depending upon the diameter, you can just see how nano wires will look like. Okay, so let us watch YouTube, because you have to visualize something and then only you can understand or just remember what I think. So I'm using you some visualization also. Okay, let us start this. So you can just see how it is looking.